Thanks. Shauna Lee Coronado is here with her new book. As you can see there, it's Gardening Nude, a common sense guide to improving your health and lifestyle by increasing exposure to nature, cultivating a green mindset, and building a strong community. And obviously you are clothed today, so explain the title of the book.
Yes, the title is just figurative. It's not supposed to be about truly gardening nude. In a metaphorical way, I'm trying to get people off the couch and out the front door and into their gardens.
Well, it's certainly a catchy title, so you had all of us running out here, all the stagehands. Look, we have about 50 stagehands out here today.
Fantastic.
Well, so what are you going to do?
I want to show you how to plant a conservation-centric pot. Mm-hmm. And the way to do it is, you know,
we have
recyclables down here at the bottom. Many people fill the entire container full of soil, and it's not necessary. Most perennials, as well as annuals, only need about this much soil in it.
Oh, is that right? So right down here to where we see the break?
Yeah, a little bit below there. Mm-hmm. And so here's a great thing, too. We're trying to keep water bottles and soda bottles out of the landfills.
Exactly.
And here we go. We're doing it. And
so then this takes up all the extra space, but you still have a large container.
Absolutely. Okay. It's very easy to lift. It's lightweight, and you can move it all around your yard. So it's really a convenient way plant a pot.
Now, all right, so how do we do it?
The first step is we want to put a newspaper or another thing that you're going to throw in the recycling anyway, right on top of those other recyclables.
Okay.
And then I'm going to have you fill it with some soil.
Okay.
And we'll start with this. Woo. Go. And then once we fill it up with soil, you keep filling. There's more down there.
Right.
I'll have you sprinkle a little more. I mix in about a quarter of compost. So one quarter compost or rotted manure to three quarters of the regular soil.
Okay.
All right. So I think that's enough soil, and we'll go ahead and show the soil moist that I'm using. This product is a mycorrhizal. It means that it has a special fungus in there that helps the plants and the roots go and grow very well. And so another trick that I use is I try to pull annuals that are drought tolerant.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so this is a drought tolerant annual. It's a proven winner's Diamond Frost Euphorbia. So after we mix all this in, we'd plant as many of these drought-tolerant perennials as we can.
Wow, that's
Petunias,
great.
Especially the supertunia, is a fabulous, fabulous drought-tolerant. That way, you're only watering your pots about once a week instead of every day.
No kidding.
It's quite a water saver. Now, there's also a way that you can plant in your regular garden beds, your perennials, the same concept. We want to save water. We want to do what's good for the earth, but it's also really inexpensive because we don't use as much water. And what we do is we mix in compost with our regular soil and more of the soil moist or mycorrhizal.
Well, that's very, we're getting a little short of time here.
That's right. And then we cover it with mulch. And you're all done.
Right.
So the idea is we're really saving gardeners water and money.
Wonderful. Shauna, thank you so much for coming in. And you can learn more about these wonderful gardening tips online at, you can go online, thecasualgardener.com.
Absolutely.
Casualgardener.com. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
Okay, those are great tips. See you later.